20 SEO suggestions for a brand new website. Number one, use Ubersuggest to find keywords. By using Ubersuggest, you can type in for free a keyword and it'll show you highly relevant keywords that you need to know for your own website. Number two, use G Suite for your email accounts. If you're going to be working in different tools for Google, you're going to want to make sure that you have a G Suite account set up so you don't have to use a domain like website.com at gmail.com. It's just going to make it a lot more professional for you. So make sure that you set up a G Suite account and you're using that Google account for your SEO practices. Number three, set up Google Search Console. You can make this happen with the G Suite account that I just told you to set up. You want to make sure you get set up to Google Webmaster Tools because it's going to allow you to index your search, index your website to the search engines. It's also going to allow you to do things like disavow bad links, submit your sitemap to the Google search engines, and do a lot of cool things like fetch and crawl your website so your website indexes very quickly, especially if you have a new website. Number four, set up Google Analytics. Just like you're going to set up Google Search Console, well, now you need to monitor your traffic. You can make this happen once again with your G Suite account, set up Google Analytics, and get it going and start sending traffic to your website so you can start to analyze who's coming to your website, how old they are, what age they are, what gender they are, how much money they make, all of these different types of ways that you can segment traffic on Google Analytics, you're gonna be able to do with your G Suite account, and I highly recommend it to any new website. Number five, you're gonna wanna do local schema markup if you're a small business locally. If you have a product, you're going to want to do a review schema markup. So when you're searching through the when people are searching through the search, they're going to be able to see that your product or service is highly reviewed. Or if you're publishing a piece of news, you're going to want to use news schema. And the way that you do this is you head over to Google's structured data testing tool, slap in your domain, see if there's any structured data on it existing. If there's not, you can go to places such as Fiverr.com. You can go to places such as Upwork. You can also do it yourself. I'm going to link down below Chase Rayner. He's very good at teaching structured data. He actually just did this recently, so go and check that out. I recommend that with every single new website so Google knows exactly what your page is about. Google came out with mobile-first indexing last year, and they said that websites are going to be indexed inside of Google based on their mobile appearance and speed. So what you've really got to do is use Google Page Speed Insights, something that you must check out for a brand new website, because you want to make sure that your speed is up to date and is faster than your competitors. Google is going to start ranking websites based on user experience. They already are doing that. So if you have a website that's really slow, it's not going to cut it in today's age and market. Use Google PageSpeed Insights, slap your domain in there, see what your score is from 0 to 100, and then follow the recommendations that they're making to optimize your website for more speed. Number seven, use Ask the Public. This is by far one of my favorite keyword research tools because it actually has data that people say and do inside of the local areas that you may be in. Go ahead to askapublic.com or go check it out. I think it's .info and start to do some keyword research ideas. You might find some things that you never would have thought to find inside of there for your brand new website if you're trying to target new keywords. Number eight, purchase an exact match domain, EMD. Google rolled something out called the EMD update, which basically said the keyword inside of the domain. For example, if you were trying to rank for Miami, Florida painter, you would buy miamifloridapainter.com, and that is an EMD, and generally those have a very significant ranking boost inside of Google almost instantly. And you can do this by making it at the top of Google. Use an EMD if you're going for a hyper-targeted keyword or if you're creating little microsites, and it's going to get you the rankings that you want very quickly. Regardless of their update, this stuff still works. I'm testing it each and every day with multiple websites that we have, and you can even go into Google search, type in painters in CT, and you'll see that our website's ranking number one because it is an EMD. Number nine, purchase a partial match domain, which is called a PMD, which is not the same as an EMD, but it still has some form of keyword inside of the domain. For example, my website is develomark.com. If I wanted to add a PMD, what I would do is develomarkseoagency.com. Does that make sense? You're putting the keyword in combination with the business name. If you do developmarkmarketing.com, developmarkseo.com, developmarkinternetmarketing.com, whatever PMD I'm adding is going to give me an extra ranking benefit. Use this at your own precaution. Don't get away from building a brand just because you want to build an EMD or a PMD, but it's always just really good practice. When somebody makes a search in Google, they look at two things. One is your title tag. Two is your URL. So you need to make sure that you're optimizing your title tag for more clicks inside of the search engines. One of the best ways to do this is to make sure that you're adding some type of social proof, call to action, or something unique inside of your title tag that your competitors are not doing. One of my favorite ways to do this is to throw the keyword into something like Ubersuggest and then see what's on the first page of Google, see what's ranking on the first page of Google, and then look at their title tags, and if it's nothing sexy going on there, if it's just general boring information, it's not going. You're going to be able to have a really great time in that market because you can do something such as call out how many reviews you have. You can do something such as how fast your service is, right? And you can call out these different attributes inside of your title tag to get a higher click-through rate, which is overall going to increase your traffic and website ranking. Number 11, place more forms on your website and ask for conversions. If you're not optimizing for conversion rate optimization, it's a metric that Google is clearly looking at when it comes to SEO, when it comes to PPC, regardless of what it may be. You need to make sure that you're optimizing for conversion rate optimization, especially on new sites. And this becomes very critical if you have leads coming into the site, submitting the forms, and you're not even getting that lead, or if you're not capturing email addresses if you're an e-commerce business or an affiliate marketing website. You've got to add more call to actions on your website so you can get more conversions, therefore increasing not only your bottom line, but also your website rankings. Number 12, reduce your website images for quicker speed. And this is very simple. Don't use PNG, use JPEG, and make sure that your images are under a megabyte. If they're over a megabyte, you fucked up. If they're under a megabyte, if they're in kilobytes, that's generally the best time to upload an image into WordPress. Regardless of the CMS that you're using, you're gonna wanna make sure that you minimize them. This can be possible done in something like Photoshop. There's a lot of tools online that do something like this, but make sure that when you're building out a landing page, your website, et cetera, regardless of what it is, just make sure that you're going ahead and you're minimizing your image files, because if you just screenshot or if you just download, a lot of the times those are megabytes big, and that's gonna slow your website down. A great way to do this is take your competitor that you're trying to outrank for the keyword that you're trying to rank for, put them in the Google PageSpeed Insights, and then just take a look and see exactly what their speed is. Go based off of that, optimize to beat them, and get more website rankings, make more money. Number 13, get more guest posts for more traffic. It's very simple. If you write content on a website that has your audience already available reading that blog, if you put in good value, they're going to get a flood of referral traffic to your website, getting more email subscribers, more form submissions, ultimately kicking ass on those other things that I told you about. And this is especially important for new websites, because if you have a new website, likely you will have no traffic, you have no backlinks, you have no say in anything, and it's very important that you start building these relationships with these other blogs that are targeting your customers. Number 14, make FAQ-styled content. Frequently asked questions. One of my favorite tips to give to my clients and my people and my students is when they're focusing in on a keyword, what questions are people asking about that keyword? What questions are people asking about, let's say, SEO? What questions do people want to know about keyword research? When you start to create a large FAQ database on a website, generally speaking, you can even create these large glossaries inside of your actual space. It's going to create a lot of links to your website because people love glossaries. People love statistics. People love looking at data. So if you create a glossary for your brand new website, just targeting all the questions that people ask you, and what you can do, my best practice for doing this, is taking out my phone. Every time somebody asks something, I just plug it in, and then I have my FAQ, regardless of what the vertical is. So if you're an accountant, you may have questions like, how can I prepare for tax time? That's a great topic for SEO, for social media. Doesn't matter where you're posting it. And that's the thing about FAQs. They're evergreen, and they're easily distributed to all of your social media sites. Number 15, why do people read? They don't. People don't want to read anymore. They want to see a visual graphic. They want to see audio. They want to see pictures. Make your content eye candy. I can't stand when I see a new website or any website just have a blurb of text and then complain as to why they're not ranking inside of the Google search engine. People don't have time. They don't want to read. They definitely don't want to look at just a blurb of text. That just hurts your eyes. Make sure that you're adding relevant media to your content. This can be things like infographics. This can be things like audio. This can be things like illustrations. This can be different types of things in your content or gifographics. Check that out, called gifographics. And it's going to really increase your dwell time, lower your bounce rate, and it's going to have a higher conversion rate because your customers love eye candy. Number 16, utilize video like the one that you're seeing now for higher dwell time and a lower bounce rate. and this is something that is so important, and it's why major brands are starting to look into video. If you've made it this far in this video, it's likely that you just listened to me talk about 15 different tips on how to get more SEO rankings. Well, if this is on my website, if that's where you're watching it, well, you've just spent 15 minutes on my website and you don't even realize it because you're watching a video. This is exactly how people are going to win in search engine optimization in 2019 and going forward. Everybody that's saying it's dead is bullshit. You've just got to figure out what's the new media strategies that experts and professionals are using to get more search engine optimization rankings. One of those ways is by creating videos. Now, you can do it with your phone. You can do it with Fiverr.com by ordering whiteboard explanation videos. You can do it by just recording stuff on your screen. That's how I started my YouTube channel. That's how I got started in my videos. And a lot of my SEO rankings attribute to the content that I produce in terms of video. So when it comes to making great, excellent content, try to add video into the mix. It's not going to hurt. It's going to increase your dwell time, and it's going to lower your bounce rate, ultimately giving you more conversions, which, like I said, helps supplement everything else that I talked about. Number 17, use Yext to optimize all of your directory listings so you have the exact match name, address, and phone number, NAP, and make sure that that's all optimized with the most relevant images and the most relevant business information about your company so that it's all spread out. In fact, Moz reported a 10% ranking factor when it comes to the Google Maps listings on locations and citations being consistent. So you don't want to miss out on that chunk of change, 10%. It's a lot, especially when you're trying to outrank, because there's real money involved when you're outranking people on Google. So make sure that you take the time to utilize a tool like Yext, Moz Local, which I don't recommend just because it's very manual. Use a tool like Yext, get it done every time you get a new client or you do it for your own business, and make sure that you're kicking ass when it comes to the Google search. Number 18. Add more images to your website and add alt text, alt tags to your images to outbeat your competitor. One of the best ways that I consult with people is by quickly going into their website and just adding an image alt tag. If you're not familiar with what an image alt tag is, it's basically what you tell Google that picture is all about. Google, unfortunately, can't see your picture. It can't analyze that data based on visuals. So you kind of have to guide it in what to do. What's the problem here? A lot of people have put a lot of pictures on their website and they don't tell Google what it is. They don't even put the keyword in. They don't even take the time to fill out the alt tag. If you're using a CMS such as WordPress, it's very easy to do once you upload the media file. On the right side, you'll see the alt tag. If you're using any other CMS or any other website builder, you're gonna have a very easy time adding in those alt tags, but just make sure that each and every one of your pictures on your website is minimized, like I said before, and has an alt text to go along with it. And don't make these alt tags just straight keyword driven. Make them actually based on what that picture is representing. That's how Google's gonna be able to read pictures and images on your website, so you might as well take advantage of it. Number 19, use internal linking for your benefit to increase your dwell time and lower your bounce rate. If you haven't noticed, a lot of this conversation has been about how you can lower your bounce rate and increase your dwell time. Google's using rank brain artificial intelligence to figure out how happy users are on your website to go against spam links, spam black hat SEO. So how can you maximize this? Well, it's very simple. It's very, very simple. If you are talking about a piece of content on your website and a user or a visitor might not know what one of the words you say means, you should have that link hyperlinked to a page on your website that explains to the user exactly what that means. That's just good user experience 101. Create content on your website, and this is why the FAQs are so great. Because a lot of the times when you're mentioning stuff on your website, you can simply link to one of your FAQ pages and the FAQ page will explain itself. So use more internal links on your website to crush the competitors in 2019. And the last tip that I'm going to give for anybody who has a new website is target your keyword inside of your URL. If you're on WordPress, you're going to want to go to your permalink settings and make sure that it's showing your post name. And your post name, every time you make a blog post, you're going to want to make sure that your keyword is inside of your actual URL. Keyword in title and meta description is a completely different debate that you can have with SEO experts, but I'm telling you right now, one of the direct ranking factors is having that keyword inside of your URL and inside of your title and make it look very, very natural. Optimally, you would want it as far left as possible because Google reads left to right, etc., but you don't have to use your keyword necessarily in your title if you don't want, if it doesn't look natural, but your URL, it's absolutely necessary. So that covers it for the 20 tips. If there's something that you think that I missed, go ahead and leave a comment down below. I'd love to know more about what you think is a good suggestion for a brand new website. If you're new to the channel, go ahead and click subscribe so I can know that you're here every time that I upload, and I'll see you guys in the next video.